do you know what? You've got to bear with me, because it's the 4th of September 2014, and this kickstarts a video diary tomorrow morning when I go down to Castle Lake in the middle of France with three of my buddies, four of us. But I've got to rewind quickly. I was at Rainbow and featured that in two parts on my June trip on the island with Arj and Jacob. I then had a trip mid-July back to Rainbow in 19 with Jim Lightfoot, which I had to cut short due to sort of personal circumstances. And that few days I was there, two, 3 days, can't remember, I'll add that to my Rainbow trip when I go back to Rainbow end of October and fish with Eric in 11. Between the Castle trip tomorrow and the end of October Rainbow trip, I'm also going to another lake, Etang 5, which is north of Paris, and I booked that with Mark Westenberg of Carping Adventures, and I go there for 1 week from the 5th of October. But anyway, we'll cross them bridges when we come to it. Right now, as I say, this kickstarts the video diary of my trip down to Castle Lake, setting out tomorrow morning, Friday morning, on the train. We're hoping to pop into Etang 5 around lunchtime on the way, because we almost pass it. Arrive at a hotel Friday night for a few beers and dinner. And then from there, it's a half hour drive Saturday morning to Castle Lake. And I think I've got that the right way round. Half past six, Friday morning, just about to board the Channel Tunnel. And there's my buddy Graham, who's looking after me all week, so I ain't got to do too much. And some of you Essex boys will know Graham from Layer, a veteran Layer angler. Well, that was easy. It's just gone 11 o'clock local time. We're at Etang 5, straight out of Calais, straight on the motorway. Absolute doddle. So compared with the mindset of driving down to Rainbow and so forth, this couldn't have been easier. So yeah, lovely morning, bit cloudy, Friday morning, and yeah, my first look at Etang, where I'll be fishing in a few weeks' time. Well, half past five Friday, that couldn't have been easier. About 4 hours, I think, to, I can't remember the name of the town, where we're having a hotel tonight and some dinner, and then it's half hour from here to Castle Lake, where we'll set off in the morning. So yeah, so far so good. Just got to make sure this ain't a camping video, like normal really. I don't mind these visits to supermarkets if it's fishing related, otherwise I think I've got a phobia about them over the years, but not chauvinistic or anything, just the way it is.
Day one.
That'll last you a day or two.
Day one, well, like, to be honest, I think...
Yeah, one day.
That will probably see us through tomorrow.
But we've got the important things, that we've got to cut the little cakes.
Oh, that's it, let's soak it up.
And we've got some wine. Well, we figure Graham won't do enough whining, so we'd better bring some wine.
Graham's getting all the stuff for the washing up.
Is he?
Yeah, how good's he?
I've left mine at home.
Yeah, he's washing up all week.
If he's got a bowl, he can do all the washing up.
Exactly that.
Bingo.
Yeah, exactly. Whose bait are you using here this week? Well, we've arrived at Castle Lake, caught up with Tom and his missus, and yeah, what is a beautiful day. But you know what, as anglers, as we were just saying, as nice as it is to set up in weather like this, you know what, as anglers, you really want nice winds, overcast, all the, you know, white caps on the water, and that's when you get them. But anyway, it is what it is. We're going to have a wander around the lake now, and have a draw. There's three other anglers turning up, so there'll be seven of us this week. So we'll have a draw for swims, and but in the meantime, have a wander around. There's the ruins there of an old castle. This is actually the stock pond. It really is an idyllic spot. It reminds me of the Lot region all round here. As we're driving in, turn it round. So the guys, as you drive in and come off the main road, just like the River Lot, that area, it's absolutely gorgeous round here. But anyway, we're going to the lakes. We're going to drive up to the main lake now and have a wander around. So, what's your first impressions, G?
Very nice.
It's beautiful.
I love that old tower over there.
It's an old castle.
Yeah.
Ruins.
Part of it, yeah.
So here we are, we've come up sort of up a hill slightly from where we were, and this is the first view of the lake.
Probably got 6 foot at the moment. The lake's at the top. This is pretty much as high as we can get it without affecting the flood in the field.
Are we on a dam here then, Tom?
Yeah, this is the dam end of the lake. Yeah,
right, yeah.
This is where we take the boards out when we're dropping the water out the lake. So the stream's at the top. Into this lake, down this sluice and the big sluice there, then it's into the stop pond, then down the side of the house where we were.
But that stop pond there, as you call it, I was expecting it to be small. It's actually a nice size lake.
Oh, it's
that
cracky,
10
mate.
Acres, is it?
Probably good 7-8 acres.
I say it's 8-9 acres.
Yeah. Right,
but yeah. It's a beautiful lake. Yeah.
And how did the lake get its name, Castle Lake?
Did you not see the castle?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a 12th century castle. I don't know the history. I need to find out really, but yeah. It's not many lakes with a castle next to it.
Yeah, no, we'll get that on the helicopter.
Like yeah, yeah, that'd be great. Yeah, don't knock it down, will you?
Yeah, no, I won't be doing that. Anyway, yeah, so what a beautiful
setting. This is the main lake, yeah. It's beautiful. You get a nice view and you get a good perspective of the size of the lake here.
Yeah. Yeah, I've got to say, don't want to labour it, but this is about one of the most prettiest places I've ever been fishing to. Really is gorgeous.
There's that much silt there, that's what I'm going to be. What's the biggest
swim
here,
Jim? One just fishing round here.
Like
the
garrus. So just having a look at random swims as we go around. This is swim 5.
You asked me how they got it round there.
How deep is it in the margin?
It's great for...
So the pads starting to die back a bit now?
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah,
you see the colours just going out of them a little bit. But like I say, 2 weeks ago here, it was like winter, freezing.
Right.
Really cold. Jumpers, trousers, it was like, God, where's summer gone?
Yeah, I think between the four of us, we're all coming to swim 10 and 11, probably thinking to ourselves, you know what, that's the swim you want. Yeah, so we'll see. I'm drawing and I get the first choice. I'm in 10, without a doubt. We'll see. There's cows and some sheep in the next field. That'll keep them Colchester boys at me for the week. I think after a few beers, Graham slept with Uglier, that's for sure. So again, a bit of mind games going on, because statistically, I'm unlikely to pull out number one. So 10 will go first off, I reckon. And I've got 16 as me next swim, which is on the far bank. So you have to go over there by boat. It's a bit of messing around. I don't think many will want to do that, but to my mind, that's the end of the lake and the area you need to be. 10 covers it perfectly well. 16 less well, but he's probably the next best bet. So I'm keeping that under me. We're all looking at each other. I'm going to get the camera out on the draw, but I'm sure anglers who are used to this draw sort of system know exactly all the mind games that are going through your heads. A bit of competitiveness, and you know, good anglers, they all know what they want and statistically where you need to be. So let's see how the mind games play out. Just waiting for the three other lads to turn up, and then we'll have our draw. Oh, and that's the castle in the background. No one lives in there now. Well, I'm in the process of setting up now. It's about 2 o'clock and I'm actually in my third choice of swim, because the boys picked out the first draw and they've gone in 16, which was my second choice, and Graham come out second and he's picked 10, which was my... No, 10 was my first choice, 16 was my second choice. Anyway, I'm in 9, so just plotting up now. There's 7 of us on the lake. We'll catch up with the other 3. They're from the Midlands as the week progresses. But, right now, doing my best. Like I say before, I start charging around. It's not like there's rain coming or anything. But I find myself running around. And you know what? I need to breathe a bit and relax. So I'm going to have a cup of tea now and plot up. We'll have a quick look at the swim as I'm setting up. Yeah, so as I say, this is swim 9. Graham's to my left, which is the end of the lake in 10. So he's down there about 60 yards or something. to that far side over there must be 200 yards, I would say. I'm probably getting on for 300 yards over there. And the boys are plotting up. You can just see them now. Tom's taking them over in the boat. That's swim 16, which is a good shout, to be fair. Tom's just asked me what time I want my dinner. About 7 o'clock, is that right for
o'clock,
you?
7 o'clock, that'll be perfect.
Yeah,
mate,
cool.
Yeah, perfect.
Yeah, so I'm in my third choice of swim, Tom, you might have gathered.
Yeah, we tried fixing the draw.
We tried to fix it, didn't we?
Yeah.
But you fixed it the wrong bloody way. But anyway, yeah, so I'm in 9, got ground to my left in 10, boys are over there in 16. So what am I looking for out here, Tom?
I would, at the moment, I wouldn't go too far out first night. I'd start fishing 80 to 100 yards. I think you've got your boat, as I can see.
Yeah.
And then maybe see how the fish go. They do like the far bank here because it doesn't get pressured. There's no lines on the far bank.
Yeah.
Sometimes the fish will go on the far bank. So if you're not getting much action, you know, you can go a bit further to the far bank.
And the first swim you can actually fish on the far bank is 16.
Yes.
Yeah, which is why I like the idea of it, and obviously the boys. And I
think,
you know, 10 and 16, they were your two sort of favoured pegs, would you say?
Yeah, they're good swims. They're persistent for catching fish. They always have been.
Yeah, so I've got to trick them out of here.
So, yeah,
you're... And I don't mind pulling strokes. Just what strokes can I pull to make sure I get their fish?
Yeah, we'll come up with a few.
We will.
Well, cool. I reckon we can drop a few in, yeah.
Yeah, cool, yeah.
But you're good here because you're all centre, you're middle of the lake. You know, if they do get a few and the fish want to come to the middle of the lake, you're in perfect opportunity to ambush fish in open water.
Because the next guy to my right is in 5, is it?
Yeah, he's got to be 150 yards away. So you've got loads of room out here.
And we've
in fact, there's no excuses, really, is there?
Do you know what?
There's no excuses. Under pressure. There's no excuses, to be honest.
But do you know what? Even like, you know, when you're full here with what is it, 12 anglers?
Maximum's 12.
Yeah, you've got plenty of scope, and there's 7 of us on the lake, even more.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's. Yeah.
I think there's enough of you to keep the fish moving around that if the fish went up that end, they could push them back down. It's enough of you to keep the fish moving around.
Yeah. Well, if I am struggling and they're having it off, honestly, just come and tell me what I've got to do because I don't care, all right? But perfect.
Brill.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's been a very easy day, Tom, so far. Well, an easy 24 hours setting out yesterday.
Yeah, it's gorgeous. Beautiful weather. Not ideal for fishing, but.
Yeah,
you know,
not ideal for fishing, but you know, it is what it is.
I can't change
it?
That, yeah.
Yeah.
I can give you a few extra chips and a bit of ketchup, you know, but. I can't change the weather.
Well, you was getting a massage earlier. I'd quite like
don't tell anyone that. I'm supposed to be, you know, it's hard work out here, look. I'm stressed, run down.
Yeah, you look it.
I had a shave for a month, but I'm struggling.
Yes. Anyway, so I'll get set up, get them out, and, you bring that dinner down at 7,
dinner warm to your swim at 7.
Yeah, perfect. That'd be days. Right, cheers, buddy. Well, the left-hand rod's already out, down by the pads, about 25 yards out. And then this rod, just going to bait up towards the back, but not over the back just yet. Not used that in about 11 years. Skirting about a bit now, and don't want to sort of rush too much video footage of what I'm doing. And equally, if it's a camping video and I've caught nothing, it might be incidental. But I've got a couple of different sort of particle rigs and boilie rigs going out on 4 rods. And we'll have a look at it sort of closer, after a day or two once I've settled down. But just quickly sticking the boat out. And this is a rig, just a plastic sweet corn rig with sweet corn out of catering size tins. There's not much in the way of nuisance fishing here, a few bream, very few bream. So having checked with Tom before we got here, you know, they drained this lake a year or so ago, took out a lot of the silver fish. So, you know, sweet corn, as we know, great bait. And if I can apply it properly and I don't get any aggro from nuisance fish, then, I think I've got a good rig. And baiting application, come to that. A little tip, especially for the Kent guys, especially you RTC boys, is when you're fishing at distance, especially at night, and you're not too sure how far out you're fishing, once you've dropped your bait, what you can do is get a little bit of elastic and put it as a marker. So when you go back out there, when you see that elastic, you know you're roughly the distance you need to put your bait. RTC, you heard it here first. Half past 7 on cue. Tom's here with me dinner.
Yeah, I've even had a shave for you, Kev.
You have a rest?
Yeah, a little 20-minute. Don't tell anyone, but yeah, a 20-minute kip.
Yeah, good lad.
Day today.
So what have I got?
You got lasagna, chips, garlic bread, and chocolate pudding with ice cream.
Oh,
all low calorie, of course.
Yeah, exactly that.
Because, you know, looking after the figure.
Yeah, happy days.
I've just got breadcrumbs and water, but, you know.
Yeah. You look crap on it.
Yeah.
So what do you do? Take it out of there and then take that back? Will you pick that
up? I'll come back up, mate. I'm going to go and have my snap.
All right, buddy.
I'll come back in 20 minutes, half an hour or so.
Super. Right. Thanks a lot.
See you later.
Cheers, Tom. Happy days. Well, this is the scene. About 8 o'clock, Saturday evening. Flat calm, looks beautiful. But you know what could do with some wind. Sunday morning, approaching 8 o'clock. Well, that turned out to be a quiet night, apart from the fact I had a coypu or whatever it was constantly going through me lines on the left two rods. So I've got to put some back leads on, that's for sure. Also the line, even nylon's having a habit of floating up. I don't know why that is. But the boys, on a positive note, opposite, Brian, Jay, they've had one each, a 50 and a upper 40. So, yeah, cracking start to the holiday for them. And, yeah, hopefully it's the start of a few to come. Could hear them in front of Graham last night. I went round to see Graham, and there was some fish directly in front of him over the back. But I didn't hear any in the night. And as I say, I was up quite a lot of the night because this bloody rat thing. But anyway, yeah, it's going to be a hot day. It's gonna be, there ain't been a breath of wind since we've been here. But yeah, a cup of tea and regroup. By the looks of things, I need to put some makeup on. Congratulations.
Massive.
Well done, boys.
Thank you, buddy.
Yeah, cracking start.
Yeah.
That's when I noticed it in the tackle shop yesterday.
Yeah, they got
line sinker.
Right, yeah, we were just
Washing up liquid.
Yeah, washing up liquid. We were just saying with the boys. But anyway, so who lost one in the night?
I did.
You lost one?
Yeah, lost one, yeah.
Yeah.
Right in the net as well.
Oh, really?
I don't think it was a big fish.
Right, yeah.
It big, so.
And have you been hearing them or seeing them in front of you?
Not seen anything in front. I've seen a couple crash down the margin.
Right, yeah.
But we've not seen anything in front of us.
And where'd you get your bites?
Open water.
Right, yeah.
120 yards, 100
yards. Both similar areas. So who had what?
I had a 49.8.
Common.
Then a 20-pound grass and an 18 mirror this morning.
Yeah, happy days. And you had what?
45 mirror.
Yeah, superb.
PB.
Yeah.
PB, yeah.
Oh, well done. Yeah. Happy days, yeah. Well done. Yeah, good start. Yeah, well
done,
boys.
Don't matter if I catch an F all else all week now, does it?
But you know, I was sitting here last night, probably like you and this morning. It's a beautiful lake, isn't it?
Stunning.
It is. I'm not too keen on the music in the background. If
what,
I'm honest.
What music?
Did you not hear nothing?
No.
Oh, someone's having a right party over the back here.
Oh, are they?
Yeah.
Oh, look, here's the one.
Here he comes. Yeah, look. Here comes Chris Yates.
Boy, they just had the Beatles on there. The four of us, the Beatles.
Well done, mate.
Thank you. Yeah, nice one.
Jay, well done, my friend.
Yeah.
Well, 9:30 on the nose, Sunday morning. And true to form, Tom's come round with me breakfast. Look at that.
What we got tonight, Tom?
Sunday roast, pork and homemade apple crumble with custard.
Happy days.
Beautiful.
Well done. Cheers, Tom.
I'll stick it on him.
I was just going to go around and see Graham. See, he was in swing 10 at the end of the lake. See, his sun will be setting in an hour or so. This bivvy of his, it's massive. Mark Hawkeye, if you're watching this, he got this idea from you, buddy. Look. I'm saying you got this off me mate Mark, didn't you?
I did. Yeah. You're a top man, Mark.
Yeah, look at that. And what bait are you using, G?
I'm using the old DT, as you can tell.
You'd never know it.
We've got the old juicy peach and sour cream on that one. Very nice too. Three different sizes. Graham. Some of them chopped up. Nice little mix.
Right. Yeah, so Graham's actually using a boat. I decided to just use my bait boat. Graham hasn't got a bait boat. So, he's got a boat. And he's fishing. You can see this is a nice swim. This is a swim I fancied, as I said earlier on the video when we first got here.
So you're at the end of the lake in a corner, all that sort of thing. Lily's over the back there. So Graham's putting his bait out. Sunday evening, and it'd be nice to get a fish between us, that's for sure.
Yeah, as I was saying, it was a quiet night, didn't hear anything either. And, you know, I feel now like I've got to move just to sort of re-kickstart myself, because now I'm just feeling a bit complacent, not fishing as hard as I could be. And I know, you know, it's only 2 days, two nights in, but, you know, there's enough fish in here to be feeling like you're on them. And right now I don't feel like I'm on them. So I'm going to be fishing the other side of the lake, further down, have some breakfast this morning. Tom's going to come round with the truck, just dump the gear in the back of the truck, take me round there, and then regroup. And as we all know as anglers, you know, sometimes a move is the sort of thing you need to sort of re-kickstart yourself up the backside. And that's my plan for today. So I'm packing up, gonna have breakfast, and this has tore off in terms of a drop back. So feels like a nice fish. Up with that. Yeah, on me, I'm photogenic. I'm still moving, but you know what? Totally out of the blue. There's a drop back. That fought really hard, that fish. Couldn't believe it. If I'd have lost it, I'd thought it was a cat. Anyway,
boily.
Yeah, well pleased with that. Yeah, cheers, boys. Well, you can imagine I'm proper chuffed with that. That really fought well, that fish. 36 and a half. And, you know, totally out of the blue, like it can often happen. But I'm still moving. I feel much more comfortable further down, margin-style fishing, as opposed to long-distance fishing here with the boat. So it's a case of, you know what, feel comfortable moving, got to move, even though I've had that fish, which I was really, really grateful for. So right now, it's not a camping video anymore. So, yeah, it's going to skirt about now. I've got breakfast coming down to the lake for 11 o'clock. Then Tom's coming round about half 12. Chuck the gear in the back of the van and get it round to the other swim. Well, it's about 2 o'clock Monday afternoon. Just plotted up now in swim, I think this was 19. So, to give you a perspective, that was the far end of the lake where Graham is still fishing and I was just before him. Brian and Jason are just round the corner there. Can't get me bearings. Over there somewhere.
and they're the boys that we've met from Leicester that are over there. So I come round here really because it's more my style of fishing, close in fishing. There's a weed bed across the back there in that far margin I can put a bait to, one around these pads, one out in open water, and then I'll put a curved ball rod somewhere down this left hand margin. So this is my spot, again a red hot day, destined to get cooler the next couple of days. Typical, you know, no sooner have I got up here, you know, what wind there is. It's a light wind blowing back down to where I was, but anyway, this is my spot for the next couple of days at least. And again, more my style of fishing. Yeah, it's nice to have a bit of breeze coming down here for you boys.
That's it, lovely.
It's nice in the shade.
Yeah, just had a shower. Crikey, you soon get wet again, it's soaking.
That's it, yeah.
It's hot.
Get some fresh rigs tied up. Fresh bait out there. Gonna try one short tonight, I've decided, Kev. What on the seam of the silt and the sand?
So what you had between you come together? Lovely looking couple.
They'd like to see that, wouldn't they?
So what's happened since you've been here then?
So you kicked it off with a 49.8 common, didn't you?
First night. You lost one.
I lost one first, then you had 49.8 common.
Yeah.
Then I had 45 mirror. Then you had a 20 pound grassy.
Then I had an 18 mirror.
And then last night we had a take at the same time, didn't we?
Yeah.
Both off the same, both of them had a bait on.
Same spot.
And we both had a bait on it. And we had a take literally within 20 seconds of each other.
Yeah.
I had a 40 pound 8 mirror. You had a 28-12 mirror, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, nice start. Yeah, good angling. Well done, boys.
Yeah, not bad.
And where you getting them out in the middle here, was it?
Well, you've had them all over, haven't you?
Yeah, mine, to be honest, just to recap, probably halfway with the left. I've had them off all rod, so on the left rod, halfway. Middle rod, out to where you were fishing.
Yeah.
Where your swim, probably halfway. I've had off this right rod, probably about 30 yards off the pontoon, out this way, so just in between our marker and the pontoon.
A lot of scope in this swim, isn't it?
Yeah.
A lot of water.
Hey? A lot of water.
Yeah, I keep getting pushed over, but yeah.
Whose swim's this?
It's mine.
It's yours. What's your rigs then? What are we doing?
I've got tungsten tubing.
Yeah.
Nice and heavy, you feel that?
Yeah. Oh, it is heavy, yeah.
Inline drop off.
Yeah.
So it does come out easily, it's just dried off a little bit. That will just pull out. It's a little 10mm that I did have on.
What's that? A snowman rig with a...
Yeah, snowman. Just it's a silty coloured braid.
Yeah, what braid's
soft,
that?
Soft trap.
Right, yeah.
Your favourite braid, isn't it?
Yeah, your favourite company makes that, don't they?
Yeah.
So, yeah, just a bit of tubing.
Yeah, slightly bent tubing.
Cool. With I like these, you don't like them, do you? But I like having something on there so I can
put sinkers. Yeah, I do, keep it
sinkers.
It's a confidence thing, isn't it?
It's whatever
you feel confident.
And that's the same as me, I like that bit there as well. Yeah, cool. And what bait are you using?
Mixture, really. I'll let you go for it. I mean, I'm using
a
bit of sticky krill.
Well, so you've got a mixture there then, boys.
Got a bit of R8 in there. DT's R8.
Yeah.
With, I think it's Pacific anchovies, a flavour in it. Quite stinky.
Yep.
Cold water with green beast. It's obviously quite fruity.
Yeah. And you're putting the particle out and stuff.
Yeah, yep. Particle and pellet.
But I've also got...
been using sticky krill.
What, hook baits?
Yeah, and freebies as well.
Yeah.
What else we got?
Essential B5.
Yeah, real mixture.
Shellfish B5. Yeah, in black and white.
We've got a few here, haven't we?
Yeah.
Tell you what, that's a lovely setting there. You don't notice that when you're fishing that bank. Look at that, it's lovely,
isn't
it?
I was saying that
road, you can go up that road, and you get a good look at the lake this way, which is better than the way we come in.
Yeah, we come in from the opposite direction, didn't we? Yeah, so I'll just have a pan round here. So there's me now in the corner. Just make me out in the middle of the viewfinder. And that's probably, that's what, 400 yards away, isn't it?
It's got to be a good 400 yards.
Yeah, 400 yards away. As we pan around, there's the Sheffield boys. Is it Sheffield?
Leicester,
aren't they? Leicester, up that one neck of the woods.
Well, they seem like they're out in Leicester when they just put their boats out.
Yeah, oh, yeah. He's only joking, boys, when you watch this back. And there's Graham over there. And now the wind's pushing down there. Hopefully he gets a bite now.
He could do with one, couldn't he?
Yeah.
He needs a fish.
Yeah. Up a bit.
How's it go, Kev? What's he need? What does he need?
Therapy.
I thought he's had that the last 2 days, bivvied up next to you. He's had plenty of therapy then, hasn't he?
He needs a fish.
Yeah. That boat, you need to get a perspective of size there. Here's me hand. That is giant.
You like that, don't you?
Yeah, that's a serious boat. I see it going out. So this is a rig Bri's using. Talk us through this, Bri. Lay it on your hands.
Got quarter end trap boom section. Mouth trap, yeah. Boom section, nice and stiff. I usually steam it straight before I put it out.
Yeah.
Loop and a quick link.
Yeah.
Then 20-pound Merlin to a Fox curve shank with a tungsten bead over the knot. And
is
then
this a pop-up rig, is it?
Snowman. Just on a swivel. So it just sits like that, but what I like about it is it doesn't matter where you add a fish picks a bait up, the hook just drops point down.
And what's the idea of that weight there?
I feel, whether true or not, it helps pull the bait into the bottom lip.
Well, that's an interesting point you say that, because that's what Andy Poynting does. And I showed that on a video at Rainbow, that he has a similar philosophy as well.
That's just a Deacomin knot, you know, to fold the thicker element over, 7 turns up, 4 turns down. Back through the loop.
Yeah, so that's like a split shot, effectively.
Yeah,
that.
Basically, yeah. I just feel it just makes it heavy and just wants to just draw that hook into the bottom lip.
Yeah, and that's like a neutral buoyancy then. So.
That's it, yeah, just an 18mm bottom bait, or 16mm bottom bait, sorry, 12mm pop-up.
Tied on.
Just for a bit of visual, really, more than anything. But I like the way the snowman sits up off the bottom.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a good anti-tangle rig as well, isn't it?
That's it, yeah. This, you know, you can throw it anywhere. You ain't got to worry about it tangling because it's nice and stiff.
How are you tying that?
That's a Deacomin knot. Oh, so you basically fold, make a loop in your thick section, pass the braid through it, whip 7 times up, 5 times down, and pass it back through the loop, and then just tease it down.
Right, yeah, sounds
so
easy enough,
you know, when you pull that bead back, it's just like that. Then just trim it off nice and tight. Just pull the bead over the knot.
Yeah, jobs are good. I'm just sitting there. My, this is the boys brought this boat down with them. Went in the transit. Cracking little boat that their mate makes. So I'm going to order one of them up. Oh. That was a fish. That's right near my right hand rod. I'm just to the left of that. Oh, happy days. Well, it's looking a bit stormy now and looking perfect. 8 o'clock Monday. Well, I think it's about 9 o'clock now and I've seen more fish here the last couple of hours than I saw up there in 2 days. Just doing that. And quite spread out between me and the guy in 3 over to my left and over in amongst the pads. So overcast, wind is dying off now, but do you know what? It done half look good. Really, really feel confident and glad I moved. Well, about 11:30, I just lost one on the right hand rod and sort of got it through the lilies. Come off bloody gutted. Oh, yeah, it just feels so right. I can't even help thinking there'll be a few bites tonight. You know, conditions are the best it's been the last couple of days. So, disappointing, that's for sure. O'clock Wednesday morning. That was a quiet night. Pressure's on.
I'm just walking round to what is my right into swim 18, and certainly don't look like it gets fished a great deal. So I just did that cutaway shot up the lake from over there. I'm fishing just round that corner. So just gonna creep up here. What I'm gonna do is just have a little look round, come back and put a few broken boilies and some sweet corn in. Because you're right in a corner here. There's lots going on. It's a definite stalking swim. So have a look. Well, you could see some fizzing there. Don't always know it's carp, but you know what? Probably more fizzing than I've seen the last few days. So yeah, just gonna trickle a little bit of bait in there and come round and, you know, while away a few hours. So it's nice and shady as well. So yeah, bit of old fashioned stalking. In fact, as I look back on the swim, it just reminds me, Punky, this is where he'd be fishing if he was here. I was talking about him yesterday, and yeah, he'd be here with his cane rod, his Mitchell 300, little quill float, about that big, and sweet corn. So John, when you're watching this, buddy, this is your sort of swim. Catch up with the boys Wednesday afternoon. I'm looking at my corner over there from swim one. This is Jamie, who's one of the three lads from Leicester. He's in five. Matt, his mate, he was on the left, has moved up to eight. So what have you had here so far?
I had 43 carp and true bream.
Right.
That's it.
Yeah. So that 43 was early on in the week, wasn't it?
That was the first night I got it.
Right, yeah.
43 pound bang on.
Feels better, I was just saying, when there's wind coming down here, doesn't it?
Yeah, the fish are moving now, I think, down to the end of that lake. Hopefully, we want to push them back up, don't we?
Right, yeah. So what's your tactics here then? What have you been doing? What's your approach?
I'm going to go about 9 yards out now, two of them on snowmans, and bait to one area. I'm going to put my left-hand rod to the far bank, about 40 yards off, and I'm putting a fourth rod out now onto lily pad pads, on a pop-up boiler, 18mm. That's about it. I'm going to try that, see how I get on tonight. If I don't know how tonight, I'll be moving to peg 7.
Right. So, move on the cards then.
Had to be done, mate. Ain't had a fish all week. There's no point sitting behind motionless rods, so off we go.
Kickstart you like it did me coming down here.
Fingers crossed, mate. Leave the bream to the bob nut here.
Yeah.
I'm off.
Yeah, good lad.
Put that. Thank you. Yeah, my tackle box.
Any luck down your end, Kev?
Pink boxers, what's going on about that?
It's my camo here.
Got them
it's my camo.
In,
yeah. Camo.
Yeah, that's for tactics, Kev. At the end of the day, like, never seen it before, don't know much about it. So obviously you're going to speak to the bailiff, Tom, who was very forthcoming, pointed out at least 6-7 marks on the opposite bank, both in the far side and in the bay. About 3 to 4 yards off of the reeds, bait semi-heavy, you know, kilo to a boilie, bit of pellet, bit of particle, which is all beautifully prepared, by the way. Put a single bait on top of it. I was just fishing bottom baits, 22 mil, size 6 hook, but I'm now going to a size 4. That's the rod we had to take on.
Here's a shed near the corner with swim 1 on the lake, where you can get your water from there. And also, you've got a fridge and freezer in here, so you can charge some lockers there. Don't really need them here. But charging facility there, and fridge and freezer as well. That's right handy. It's only a couple of minutes walk from our swim. I'm standing now on the sort of end, not sure if it's the dam end of the stock pond, but you can see the castle behind me. I'm just going for a shower now. And that castle, I got it on the helicopter as well yesterday. And I'm not too up on the history, but I think that might have been built like 2,000 years ago by the Egyptians. So it's really old. And there's ruins behind it as well. So quite an interesting thing to get on camera, that's for sure. Just had a shower and have a quick look at the facilities. There's the two lavatories there, a couple of big sinks, and three showers. Superb, nice and clean, hot water. Yeah, as good as it gets. Ever get that feeling, I can't buy a bite? It's now 8 o'clock, Thursday morning. Really thought I was in with a chance last night. Dead quiet. The boys had one up on the right in 16. Heard it flapping in the mat. So it'd be interesting to see what they had last night, along with everyone else. But down here, dead quiet. Really was disappointing. That's fishing. Thursday evening, 7 o'clock on the nose. Look at that. That'll cheer me up. Well, it's 9 o'clock Friday morning. And it pains me to say it, I lost another one about 3 o'clock this morning. Got it in from over the back, across that weed, where I dropped the bait yesterday, and lost it in the pads just down here. So really disappointing, not good. I've hook pulled on 3 fish now. Well, accidents happen. I'm cutting up the meat. It slipped and cut me bloody finger on that edge. But you know what? Kent boys, straight up the hospital stitches. Me, Essex boy, conditions like this, no way I'm leaving the lake. Probably lost about a pint of blood. But you know what? Gotta catch a fish. Tom's come down with the emergency kit.
Dr. Tom. Look at that. Sure you'll survive. Bad that is.
Ah! Oh, you're good, aren't you?
There
That's
you go.
It's going to last about 2 fucking minutes.
You've got a spare one.
Am I?
Got a smaller one. You might be better off with a smaller one.
I tell you what I'm better off doing, actually running it round the finger, I mean.
It won't go round.
Huh?
In fact, I only put it there so you can pull it off to watch it.
All right, then. Have you got a kit in there I can sew up myself?
Maybe we should cut it off.
I'll sew it up myself.
The hand.
I don't need no anaesthetic or anything.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's done, job.
It's not bleeding, is it? It's not bleeding, that's the main thing.
Exactly.
And you're here, and we won't want to lose you, because you're
And I'll tell you what, I am special. And look at them conditions out there.
Perfect.
No, no way excuses. I'm going anywhere.
No, yeah? No.
All joking aside, Tom wanted to take me up the hospital. He said it was really bad, and under normal circumstances, any other angler would probably be straight up there, even called an ambulance to the lake. But I said, no, just put a plaster on it. Conditions are good. I need to catch a fish before I get home. That's commitment.
Well, this is a view, just gone 7 o'clock Saturday morning, and that feeling of waking up, having not caught.
Used to work on Harrow. Last minute. Well, it's about 8:30 Saturday morning, and packed up. Graham's on his way around to pick me up to the clubhouse for a shower. Graham had 3 in the night, so he done well. Jay had 1, Matt had 1, and I think that was the night activity. So, in summary, tough week for me, but you know what? That's fishing, and I'll be back. We'll save the synopsis for when I get home.
And here is my parting shot of the lake. What a beautiful complex this is, and I can't wait to get back here.
Well, I'm just going to say goodbye to our boys and make tracks to Paris. There's Matt.
Brilliant week.
Great, cracking week, wasn't it?
Fish on the last night.
Well, there's everyone here saying our goodbyes. I can see Sue and Dave, they're getting emotional. Well, I ain't met you before. I've probably had a lasting effect, haven't I?
Come here.
Yeah.
It's a kind of
group hug. Sue, lovely to see you, yeah? Might see you again down here then, yeah?
You never know.
Yeah, you're from your travels to Spain for the winter, are you?
That's correct.
Yeah, nice one. All right, well, have fun, guys. And great to meet you.
Have a safe drive.
Yeah, we'll do. Mark. He's on the walkie-talkie.
Last night.
Shouting, Mark. I'm thinking we ain't got a Mark. We're going to call you Mark from now on.
I know. That's going to stick.
Yeah.
But yeah, at least you've all had a good week.
We have. Been a cracking week.
In great fashion, what we've actually done is forgot to video any of this. So we're just going to video releasing the £40.
Side in a sec.
There we go. A lovely £40, what was it, Mirror?
£40.8.
£40.8 caught in the night. Or early hours this morning, I should say. You got a bit of a PYB going on there.
There she goes. Then she's off.
There goes Jay, en route to the far margin with his full rod. Using the rowing boat because his bait boat's broke down once again. I reckon it's a good 120, 140 yards to the far margin. But as nobody can fish from that bank, seems pretty obvious that most of the fish are going to be holed up there somewhere. Seen a few fish crash out there, nothing much. But in all fairness, haven't really seen much crash anywhere. Don't know if you can still see him in the viewfinder. Surprising how much that boat sinks down with that fat git in it. Good job Graham put the buoyancy aids in it, really. I don't think he's going to go tight to the margin. I think he wants to come about 20, 30 yards off, just dropping off into the deeper water. It's probably only 18 inches, 2 foot tight up to those reeds. So he's coming off a bit where it drops down to sort of 4, maybe 3, maybe 3.5, 4 foot. Go. Baiting up with several balls of Vitaling dog food as ground bait. A whole heap of pellet and monkey sick, otherwise known as Castle Lake's particle mix. If you've ever been here and used it, or if you ever come here and use it, you'll understand why we call it monkey sick.
Alright. Tell us about it then, Brian.
38, 12 pound of mirror carp, caught about 4 o'clock this morning, right hand rod at about 120 yards. Fought like an absolute demon all the way in. If I'd have lost it, I'd have sworn it was bigger, but can't be upset with a 39, 12, can you?
It's a stunning fish, if I'm honest.
Yeah.
Beautiful mirror.
Let's see about getting it back, shall we?
Yeah, why not? Do we'll film this release just because we ain't done a lot of footage when we should have done, but we have been a bit busy.
Yeah.
So as you can see, it's quite important that Brian's checked to make sure the fins are back, not going to get caught. fish's belly. The line of the bottom of the net is in line with his bottom of the belly.
Well, it's, you know, I've been thinking about, I've been trying to do the synopsis and I keep laughing because, you know, a couple of things from that holiday just make me smile that will stay off camera. But anyway, yeah, guys, what a cracking week that was. And as frustrating as it was for me in terms of catching one and losing a few, first and foremost, we were a great bunch of boys and we met a great bunch of Leicester boys. Guys, when you're watching this, yeah, really enjoyed your company and look forward to seeing you again. And as for you, Tom, and Maureen, your other half, you couldn't have done more to look after us. Food was fantastic. Your advice was first class. Great venue. And, you know, for anyone considering going to France, not necessarily wanting a Runswater. You can't look at Castle, and it certainly weren't a Runswater for me. You know, it's a great place to go. Nice size water at 40 acres, picturesque as you like, and extremely well run. So, yeah, guys, yeah, congratulations to, you know, you, Tom, you know, the owners for running, you know, a first-class fishery. Angling lines, you know, the booking arrangements, all very straightforward. So, yeah, top-notch. And, yeah, in summary, you know, I did find the fishing a bit difficult, you know. Should I have moved? Was it a good idea? Hindsight's a great thing. I felt, you know, more comfortable fishing closer in amongst them pads and stuff than I did sort of long distance with the boat. But, you know, hindsight's a great thing in carp fishing. And, you know, all said and done, I tried me little tricks and stuff and, you know, got a couple of bites but didn't convert them. The pictures you'll see overlaid are of some of the fish the boys caught, and there were some great fish caught. Everybody caught. You know, there were seven of us on there. Everyone caught fish, and that's what makes the holiday particularly nice. So, as I say, that's a quick synopsis of the week. Hope you enjoyed the video, and, yeah, I look forward to getting back to Castle with the boys and even you Leicester guys who we'll be catching up with sooner than later. So, yeah, thanks for watching, and, yeah, I'll be back.
So you cutting it, I'm catching it, was it?
Yeah.
Alright. I'll turn around, you alright now? You're on it. Hold on. Fucking happy days. Well done. What a team effort that was. Fucking hell. Yeah. Give me five. Well done, buddy. Fucking hell.